There's a variety of specialities that an organization may use to operate and drive cloud-native best practices and processes. This video covers these professions, the differences between them, and how they actually relate to each other. This video is also useful for those considering career options available within tech organizations. So firstly, the DevOps engineer. A DevOps engineer will have a skill set that spans the two main keywords specified. The role is a natural evolution from what many organizations compartmentalized as development and operations. In some organizations, this causes challenges owing to the respective priorities for each entity. A DevOps engineer will generally have a bias in their skill set towards development, but will also have skills that complement the operations role, and in particular, the expectations and standards that operations promote. Typical skills of a DevOps engineer may include infrastructure provisioning, system administration, storage, networking, internet services, automation and scripting, and much, much more. It's common when talking about the role of DevOps to see the DevOps infinity loop that relates quite nicely to the different technical skills and experience. This is an example of some of the different areas and how they actually relate. Whilst knowledge about various areas are essential to the role of a DevOps engineer, advocacy is also an essential ingredient for success and very much relates to a cloud-native culture. Not only should a DevOps engineer be able to collaborate and communicate the pros and cons of a given solution, they should have an ethos for driving change and promoting cloud-native practices. Next up, the site reliability engineer. Site reliability engineering is an area that became extremely popular through entities like Google, where it was founded back in 2003 and can be seen as an area that has a crossover with DevOps. Reliability and reliability at scale is a challenging problem. For an entity like Google, a problem that affects 1% would be exponentially larger than a problem that affects 1% of users in many other organizations. This article nicely summarizes it, and at Google scale, million to one chances happen all the time. Site reliability engineering focuses more heavily on reliability. There is an emphasis on uptime, availability, scalability, resilience, robustness, and the ability to rapidly resolve unforeseen problems. An SRE will focus more specifically on the creation and implementation of SLAs, SLOs, and SLIs. SLAs, service level agreement. Our service should achieve 99.99% uptime. SLOs, service level objectives, i.e. a response from this service will always take less than 200 milliseconds. SLIs, service level indicators. Indicators that provide an insight into the success of SLAs and SLOs. For example, we are achieving 97% uptime and our response time is 300 milliseconds. Therefore, we are meeting neither our SLAs or SLOs. SREs are also responsible for the management and handling of an incident management process and for coordinating and deriving the lessons learned post-incident. Next up, CloudOps Engineer. Cloud operations is a growing discipline that focuses on the management, delivery, and optimization and consumption of workloads running on cloud infrastructure. There are parallels between the DevOps and CloudOps, and again, using the analogy of the DevOps infinity loop, CloudOps has a focused emphasis on the right-hand side of the loop, in particular, deploy, operate, and monitor. These areas would be more focused and aligned with cloud technologies. For example, in the deploy subsection for DevOps, we may see the use of configuration management tools such as Ansible, Chef, and Puppet, as typically in the DevOps paradigm, we would be working with managed servers and assets that we control, closer alignment to the operating system. under the role of CloudOps, deploy may be more aligned to resources that have a heavier emphasis on cloud, i.e. the use of cloud compute resources or tool sets like Terraform, which can be used for infrastructure as code deployment across different cloud offerings. The security engineer. A security engineer specializes, as the name suggests, in IT security and will typically have a holistic view and expertise that covers many different areas of IT security, ranging from attack vectors and best practices within operating systems to network-based security, external threat detection, and reduction. The role of IT security in many organizations is less hands-on and instead focuses on promoting and adhering to security best practices, as well as the cultural change for adopting security as an organizational mindset. This leads us nicely to the DevSecOps engineer. DevSecOps is an interesting paradigm that is generally considered to be a DevOps engineer with security knowledge and experience taken from the security engineering role, in addition to the subset of DevOps expertise. A DevSecOps engineer may provide an emphasis on security principles which can complement existing teams and organizations as an addition or an alternative to DevOps. A DevSecOps specialist may, for example, work in conjunction with DevOps to specifically add automation that complements CI/CD pipelines, i.e. code container vulnerability scanning, as part of a code sign-off delivery process. DevSecOps can also be viewed from a cloud-native viewpoint as a positive way of promoting security best practices and principles throughout the entire DevOps lifecycle. Whilst DevOps was the bridge between development and operations, DevSecOps can be considered the bridge between traditional IT security and DevOps. Then we have the full-stack developer. A full-stack developer is a developer who specializes both in front-end development, what is today commonly seen as web front-end, so the likes of JavaScript frameworks, the React and Angular. Then, of course, there's also the classics, HTML and CSS. But front-end development can also apply to other front-ends, so, for example, iOS and Android applications, Windows or Mac graphical user interfaces, and there's a plethora of examples that can actually relate to front-end. Back-end development, this for example could be your server-side processing that the application interacts with, possibly through the use of secure API calls. For back-end development, the list of opportunities is huge, and again, common examples, you've got Golang, Rust, C, C++, Python, and it's common for these systems to actually have interaction with other components, so things like data stores, databases, or other services. As a full-stack developer, they will typically be proficient in a variety of different software development areas and are able to complement projects with the interaction between front-end and back-end components. The cloud architect, responsible for architecting cloud applications, infrastructure, and solutions. And naturally, given the decisions and direction involved, they play an important role in a cloud-native culture. As part of the architectural process, an architect may need to decide and consider the actual target cloud platform or platforms in the case of multi-cloud, the choice of cloud tooling and resources, for example, infrastructure or FaaS offerings, cloud-native components that provide interoperability and or reduce the likelihood of vendor lock-in. They also need to assess whether or not a service offering fulfills the required parameters, i.e. costs, performance, observability, reliance, and automation. The role of cloud architect will often involve intercommunication with other areas and, much akin to the DevOps role, interpersonal skills for collaboration are highly beneficial. There is typically interaction with many different areas and roles, i.e. management, DevOps, CloudOps, security, and more. And the last one we're going to cover, data engineer. Data engineering is a role that can span a variety of different areas of data expertise and disciplines. While the role itself can vary significantly, the role of a data engineer is to design and build systems that can manipulate and provide access to data according to the needs of the organization. Depending on the role, this may be data that needs scale en masse. It could be large data sets that need to be processed in a distributed way for fast access, the creation of algorithms to convert data into useful information that can be accessed elsewhere, and creating tools or processes to verify the datasets are compliant. Again, with an area so specialized as this, a cloud-native mindset that strives for cloud-native principles is highly desirable. So to summarize, we've covered the various types of personas and the differences between common profiles such as DevOps and site reliability engineering. The big takeaway is how these roles are not mutually exclusive and will often complement each other. Therefore, making it desirable for an organization to hire individuals from these distinct specializations. I hope you enjoy this video, and I'll see you in the next one.